It's been 90 days with the M4 Mac Mini, and the question is, has it lived up to the hype? Well, I've used it every single day, and I put it through real world tests, and I've got some thoughts on it. We're talking about the good, the bad, and whether or not you should buy one. Let's dive right in. Starting with what makes the M4 Mac Mini stand out as being a great desktop computer. Well, mostly, there are some trade-offs that we'll get into in a few minutes, but first, the M4 chip delivers serious power whether you choose the entry-level M4 or the beefier M4 Pro. You get rock-solid performance for everyday tasks, creative work, and even gaming. But you want to know what else is going to be rock-solid? Subscribing for more Apple-related tech reviews. And speaking of things that you wouldn't expect, gaming on a Mac, it works very well for games that are optimized for Mac, but with the M4 chip, performance is even better. The M4 excels at the fundamentals. Email, web browsing, spreadsheets, all without even turning on the fan or breaking a sweat, depending on how you want to think about it. And for creative tasks, whether you're editing video, working with high resolution images, or just handling pro level tasks, the M4 Mac Mini doesn't just keep up, it makes everything that you do really just kind of seamless. Now, storage can make or break your experience, and the M4 Mac Mini is great because it gives you a lot of different powerful options. Apple's SSD speeds are top tier, meaning that whether you go with the base model or max it out, you're gonna get blazing fast storage that keeps up with everything feeling instantaneous. Now, if you need serious storage, Apple gives you room to scale. The M4 Mac Mini starts with 256 gigs of storage and goes all the way up to 4 terabytes, while the M4 Pro, like I have, starts at 512 and maxes all the way out to 8 terabytes. But there's a catch. Apple charges a premium for those upgrades. They are an arm and a leg. Now for some, paying up front for internal storage is worth it, especially if you need the fastest speeds possible, plus you need the security of it being built into the computer itself. But for others, there are way better ways to get more storage without paying Apple's extortionistic pricing. You can get something like a Samsung T5 or a T7 and plug it in, and it's really, you're gonna just set it and forget it. It is affordable, it's portable, and it's easy to set up, but it is slower than internal SSDs, and it's gonna take up a USB port, which obviously is not great. Now, if you're looking for a better option, I have this M4 hub and stand from Satechi. This gives you the ability to add additional ports, which we all know that Mac Mini is sorely in need of, with the ability to add an M.2 SSD underneath here for additional functionality. I have a 2 terabyte Samsung here, and it's all gonna be channeled through or put through this integrated braided cable that plugs into the back of your Mac Mini. Now, it's not as fast as Apple's SSD, but for most people, it's gonna be fast enough for everyday work. And for transparency, this video is not sponsored by Satechi. I bought this with my own money and the drive and everything. But if you want a review of the hub in depth, let me know down in the comments below. But for most people, external or integrated storage is gonna be the smarter, more cost-effective choice. And that's really the beauty of the M4 Mac Mini. It's really build your own setup where you have options. Now, Apple redesigned the cooling system on the Mac Mini, and there's without a doubt, this just works. Now, some people claim that they can get the fans to turn on, which I'm sure if you throw everything at it, you know, heavy exports, complex AI models, and even stress tests, you're gonna hear the fans. They're cooling down the machine, and it's supposed to do that. But in my experience of using this for the past 3 months, there have maybe been a handful of occasions where I've got the fans that kick on where it's like 75% load or 100% load. So without a doubt, the Mac Mini will certainly be quieter and use less power than your Intel-based Mac Mini, than your M1, M2 Mac Mini. Now, in speaking of efficiency, number 5 is about connectivity. Starting up front, we have 2 10 gigabit USB-C ports right here on the front, followed by the 3.5 millimeter jack and then the status light. On the back here, we got 3 Thunderbolt ports. We have HDMI 2.1, gigabit Ethernet, and then we also have the power port. Now, these ports are Thunderbolt 4 on the base M4 Mac Mini, while you're gonna get more robust Thunderbolt 5 on the M4 Pro. But the accessories, they're actually more expensive. But if you do have the peripherals and the use cases that support it, like this OWC Thunderbolt 5 drive that I have here in the SSD, you're unlocking 3 times as much bandwidth, means faster external storage, high-speed networking, and even more powerful workflows. Now, next, another underrated feature of the M4 Mac Mini is that it supports up to 3 external displays, depending on whether you get the M4 or the M4 Pro. It's perfect if you're a creative, a coder, an office worker. You're gonna get all this additional display pixels when working with 6 and 5K resolution screens, giving you plenty of real estate to kind of spread out and kind of get the lay of the land and get everything nice and perfect wherever you need it for multitasking. And let's wrap up with my favorite aspect of the Mac Mini, and that's the incredible value that you get. Now, the entry-level Mac Mini is $599. If you're following my price checker, which is linked down in the video description, you can often find it for $549. And Apple also started selling refurbished M4 Mac minis on their website for just over $500, making it an even better deal. But no matter which price you snag one at, the M4 Mac mini delivers outsized performance. A big part of that performance advantage is inherently in the way that it's modularly designed. There's no display, no keyboard, no mouse, giving you the ability to customize it to make sure that it matches your workflow. This allows you to make your setup as simple or as extravagant as you want. Now me, I'm kind of extra sometimes. I pair mine with Apple Studio Display like I have back there, but you don't need to spend that much to get a great experience. There's the Asus ProArt PA27JCV, which is an excellent alternative to the Studio Display, but at a more affordable cost of $799. Now I'll include a link to that video at the end of this one so you can check it out when we're done. When you compare it to a much more expensive Mac, that is the thing. This lowers the barrier to entry, giving everyone the most powerful computer in Apple's lineup for $599. Now, for all the things that are great about the Mac Mini, including this retro Apple sticker here, which I'll have linked down in the video description, there are a few drawbacks which you want to make sure that you think about before making that purchase. Let's talk about that next. And first, it's the starting configuration on the M4 Mac Mini. Now, 256 gigs is not enough storage in 2025. It is entirely way too small. If you're a prosumer, a pro user, or you're just someone who wants to keep your computer for several years, like most people do, I think that you're gonna run out of storage very fast. Now, once you factor in macOS apps and the fact that they're not getting any smaller, and by that extension, the apps or the data that you use to that save with those apps is not getting any smaller. So at minimum, I'd recommend 512 gigs of storage. And if you don't wanna pay Apple's steep upgrade extortionistic pricing, I cover the alternatives earlier in the video. Now, technically, you can upgrade the internal SSD on the base M4 Mac Mini, not the M4 Mac Mini Pro yet as of this video. That's if you're willing to take some serious risk and void your warranty, and I don't think it's for the faint of heart. But the bottom line is, right-size your storage purchase because there's no upgrades post-purchase. Now, Apple finally ditched the 8 gigabytes of RAM, making 16 gigs the new baseline, and that is awesome. Just because Apple upgraded what would be the floor of how much RAM they need doesn't mean that you need to discontinue thinking about whether 16 gigs is gonna be relevant for you or whether you should upgrade. For most people, 16 gigs is gonna be fine, but if you're using Apple Intelligence, maybe even Pro Apps, or you're a Chrome user, you wanna future-proof yourself, and I'd strongly recommend 24 gigs or the next tier up, depending on which Mac that you buy. More RAM is never a bad thing, and it's like the one thing that you'd upgrade that you really never will regret. Now, the next thing that I don't like about the M4 Mac Mini is that the Mac Mini still, we don't have Wi-Fi 7. Now, is it a deal breaker today? No, probably not, because you might or may not have a Wi-Fi 7 network at your home. 802.11ax Wi-Fi 6E is still really fast, but let's not kid ourselves, because even as fast as it is, Wi-Fi 7 is here, and I can bet that most of you watching this video are gonna keep your Macs for 4, 5, 6 years, and at some point, future-proofing really would have been nice on this device. Now, the next thing to hear is that there is still no SD card slot here on the front. We talked about what the ports here on the front. Would I have preferred a slightly taller Mac Mini with an SD card slot? Absolutely. But here's the reality. If you really need an SD card slot, you only have one option in Apple's lineup, and that's gonna be the Mac Studio. You know, that's a reality that I don't wanna face because that's much more expensive. Again, you could get a third-party adapter, a hub, a dongle. There's just a ton of different options, but we don't want the options after post-purchase. We want them built into the machine. Now, the truth of the matter is that while none of these issues themselves are deal breakers on their own, they really might be depending on what your workflow and what your needs are. But is it worth it? Let's wrap up and figure that out. So after 3 months of daily use, I think that the M4 Mac Mini has proven to be the best value Mac that Apple's ever made, full stop. Whether you're just an everyday user looking for fast, reliable computing or a creative professional who needs a rock solid performance, the Mac Mini delivers. Now, I think that maybe if you're a creative professional, the lack of the SD card might be a deal breaker for you, but you let me know. Now, everyone asks me, Mike, what configuration do I get? How much money do I even need to spend? Well, let me tell you what I have here. This is the M4 Pro, which I don't think that you need. Not everyone needs that for sure. It's got 512 gigs of internal storage, so it's the base level storage, and it's got 24 gigs of unified memory. I think that everyone, you know, if you're seriously consider buying this and you're gonna keep it for a number of years, don't skip out on the internal storage unless you are comfortable with that trade-off of external storage that might not be as fast and you're gonna spend some money to get to that. But definitely consider upgrading and getting more RAM. But now this is a chance for me to turn it over to you. I wanna know if you already own a Mac Mini, what configuration did you buy, and are you happy? In hindsight, did it work out for you? And if you haven't bought a Mac Mini, What questions do you have? Let us know down in the comments below. And if you made it this far, drop a Shamrock emoji so I can know who my Mac Mini enthusiasts are. My name is Mike. Make sure you are subscribed for more tech content, including more Mac Mini content. I'll talk to you guys in the next one. I'm out of here.